What up, crew? Chaz here, Side Hustle Pros. Look who I found.
What's going on, everybody? Steve here, raking profit with Mr. Charles Leslie, Side Hustle Pros.
Yes, sir. We got both recordings going right now. We're on YouTube Live, Side Hustle Pros, and we're doing a pre-recording for Mr. Raking here. So what did we just do?
So we're over here in Las Vegas for the ASD event, bunch of conferences, and it was, well, it's about 10:30 in the morning. We got here about 9 a.m. We're at Planet Fitness, and we just crushed an awesome workout. And how do you feel right now?
I feel freaking on fire.
You feel amazing, ready to start the day.
It's so different when you go to the gym every day by yourself, and then it's two of us that have like minds about fitness and how that carries over to your business. And so we're in here for an hour and a half, went by like that. We freaking crushed it. It was amazing.
Yeah, we had that that bro science, like we had that vibe going on, and yeah, time flew by, feeling great. And you know, you got 4 hours of sleep.
Yeah.
I got 5 hours of sleep. I had a million excuses that I could have used.
Yeah,
and I'm not gonna lie to you. I'm gonna be 100% honest.
Yeah.
Last night at about 2 a.m., I thought of messaging you and saying, Charles, I'm just not gonna have enough sleep to get to the gym. Did you have any thoughts like that? Or?
Yeah, I texted this guy. No, you messaged me at like 7
yep.
this morning. We had agreed on 8 a.m. we were gonna hit the gym. And we both got severe lack of sleep last night. And so at 7 a.m. he messaged me and says, hey, are you good for 8? And I said, yeah, actually, I'm good for 9 so I can sleep longer. And so the thought was definitely there, like, I really do not. I love raking. I want to show up for him, but I do not want to do this workout.
Yeah, I thought to myself, how many opportunities do I have to, like, meet up with someone like yourself, a YouTuber, like, you know, and have a workout? I'm like, I can't let my excuses get to me. And one thing I want to mention in this video for everybody watching, the difference between failure and success and getting the results you want and just being normal are those little tiny decisions you make that you can easily do, but easily not do.
Yeah, absolutely. The biggest thing to drive home here, guys, is the title of this video. It's not clickbaity or anything, but it was your best business equals your best self. And we were talking about this when we were in the gym in between sets. Like, I feel so amazing after I take care of me, whether it's nutrition, some of you it's gonna be spiritual life, meditation, like taking care of yourself, making yourself a priority, taking care of your physical body. When you feel good and you have more energy and you think clearly, you can go out and source longer, you can ship faster, you can do all these things and you still have energy at the end of the day.
And for me, it's the creativity, the confidence. And I was telling Charles, like, you know, behind the scenes, when I'm not eating well, when I'm not taking care of myself, when I'm not working out, 100% honest, I'm gonna be really transparent here, I'm very depressed. I'm not happy with my life. I don't wanna socialize. I don't wanna, you know, I don't wanna push myself. So the creativity and the confidence is a big thing. When you take care of yourself, it wasn't long ago, I weighed 240 pounds, smoking 2 packs of cigarettes. This was 5-6 years ago. I was depressed, I had nothing. And you know, I would, if you were offering me $1 million right now or to have amazing health, I would take the amazing health all day long. And that's not just like some like weird thing I'm trying to say.
Yeah. Makes total sense, because you can take your health and go easily make $1 million. But and I go through the same thing. That's why we connected so well today, is we both have gone through the same similar journeys and similar struggles too. Especially we're in Vegas right now.
I know.
Get this, we're in Vegas. We haven't cheated on our diets at all.
It was I had I'm gonna sound like such a little girl. I had 2 chips.
Oh,
I just had a chip and I tasted it and I'm like, I'm leaving the house.
We definitely burned that off in here.
Yeah.
But point being, like, we have shown up to we've worked out the whole trip. We've been here. This is the first time we worked out together.
Yeah.
But we worked out both days so far. We've been on track with our nutrition. We're gonna go home and we're gonna feel like $1 million. We're gonna be better shape and in better shape and better people when we go home than when we came here. Versus, I know what I used to do, especially on trips, because we both travel a decent amount. I used to use that as a vacation excuse to pig out, skip my workouts, and be like, oh, I'm on vacation, I'm just gonna network, I'm gonna have a good time, drink too much. I felt like shit every single day.
Yeah.
It's not worth it.
If you're gonna go to an event, you know, we're over here, ASD, private label conferences, networking. People don't realize it, but it takes so much energy to really network with people and give back and be able to really listen and contribute and add value to them. Like, it takes a lot of energy to network and learn. So if your diet's on point and you're not feeling good, you're shooting yourself in the foot. I'm getting ready to go to Tony Robbins
after this.
And I'm going with, you know, Jameson Philippi. You guys probably know Jameson.
Yeah, absolutely.
You know, show some love to Jameson, awesome hustler. I'm bringing him to the Tony Robbins event for the first time. And I was telling him,
amazing.
You need to make sure we're gonna be green juicing, ginger shots, like meditation, because it takes so much out of you, these events.
It does.
It's important. Work out first thing in the morning too.
Yeah. It really, like, we were talking to somebody yesterday and they asked, you know, what do you do when you work out first thing in the morning and it drains your energy for your typical day, your job, right?
Yeah.
We're talking about that, and yeah, you're gonna be tired in the beginning, but there's a switch that happens when you're consistent with it that, like, both of us, we work out in the morning because it gives us energy for the day, and especially at a conference like this, like, we run YouTube channels, so people think we're the most outgoing people, but we're both kind of hermits in a way where we like our quiet time, so at events, it is extremely mentally exhausting, believe it or not, to talk with people all day long and network. So if you feel like crap all day because you're not taking care of yourself, you're not going to have confidence when you're speaking to somebody or networking. You're not going to have energy to last all day. And here we are. We got 4 hours of sleep. We still at the gym. We feel like $1 million and we're going to go have a blast today too.
It's crazy. I've had a lot of people come up to me and they're not talking to me about techniques and strategies to make more money and build their business. They're asking me, how did you get fit? How did you lose weight? How do you get in shape? Like, a lot of us in the community think all we care about is making money, but it's not the truth. Yeah. Like, people don't want money just to have pieces of paper. Who cares? What are you gonna do with this? Make a fire? I mean, you know what I mean. But people want the freedom. They wanna have time to work out and take care of themselves, take care of their family, and people want their health.
They do.
But the reselling community in general, and I hope this doesn't come off in the wrong way, because this was me before too. A lot of people in the reselling community are very, very just unhealthy, and it's not because of them. It's not your fault. It's not our fault. It's because we're sitting at a computer all day long.
Yeah.
You know, so it's tough. People want their health.
Yeah.
They do. They know how important it is. So it's like, that's one thing I've really been spreading is the importance of, and that's why I ran this video, the importance of eating right, getting out there and exercising. It's a journey.
It really is. And it's funny, I come from a background of being a health and fitness coach. So before Amazon doing health and fitness coaching, I was in great shape, coaching my clients, having a blast. I got in e-commerce. I, as the fitness coach, I put on like 30 pounds in 2016.
Been there, done that.
Because of that, I was doing a lot more computer work. I was slaving over the boxes and the tape all day long. My body felt like crap. Mentally, I wasn't there, disconnected from my relationships, and it affected everything, and I didn't even realize it because I wasn't putting myself first. It was very spread thin. I know you and I both love side hustles, right? So we spread ourselves
side
thin sometimes.
Bros.
And I remember spreading myself so thin throughout 2016, and those on my channel have heard me preach this before. And I finally just hit that breaking point. I'm like, you know what? I need to take care of me so I can feel better, so that my family gets the best version of me, my business gets the best version of me. And when I started doing that, I lost the 20, 30 pounds that I put on, and I feel great again.
So what tips would you have to somebody who's watching either on the Rake and Profit YouTube channel or, you know, Side Hustle Pros? If you guys aren't following him, for the people on Rake and Profit, Side Hustle Pros YouTube, I think you just passed, 50,000 subs?
Just hit our 50K.
Wow, that's awesome.
Keep up with this guy here. He's going to be first across 100.
Yeah, but I had a big head start. You caught up quick.
Yeah, a little bit.
But what advice would you have for somebody who's watching this and they're like, that's great. Like, Steve, like, you're making it happen now. Yeah. Charles, like, you're a coach. Like they're thinking to themselves, like, I want to, like, put myself first. Like,
Like,
maybe they're starting to make money, they're building their business, they're doing well, but they want to start to get fit. What's the best piece of advice you give them?
I mean, there's a lot of little, like, you know, here's the best way to work out, here's the best nutrition plan. Like, none of that really matters. Like, you'll figure that stuff out. There's so many options as far as workouts and nutrition plans go. Just choose one and stick with it. But aside from that, my biggest tip I give people is you have to make the time. We preach the same thing.
That's a great tip. You couldn't have had a better tip.
No, seriously,
that's
an amazing tip. We both talk about this. We all have the same 24 hours in a day. So when I do this, I'm guilty of this too, where I tell someone, like, oh, sorry, I didn't get this done. I'm busy, right? You can choose whatever you want to do with your day. And here's the killer part that a lot of people don't like to hear is the fact that if you're talking about fitness and getting healthy, you have to wake up early, you have to work out on your lunch break, or you have to stay up late. Like, those are your options. Just like building a business, fitness and business are directly correlated. And that's why we love both.
You got to figure out your schedule and what works best for you. Yeah. I experimented with midday workouts and late day workouts.
Yeah.
And you've got to understand how your brain works. We all have a little, I don't know, it's like our subconscious or what it is, our little devil inside of our head that, like, you just know what you're able to do and what you're not able to do. Like, if I try to do my workout mid to later in the day, I use feeling full or not having energy or, like, being burnt out from caffeine as an excuse.
Yeah.
There is no excuse first thing in the morning. Yeah, you feel like crap at first, but once you get it over with, you feel great. Like, mornings works for me, but if you work at like 4 a.m, it might not be the best for you. But you're gonna have to sacrifice lunchtime or dinner. Like, you, there's no way around it.
Yeah, that's the key too, is the sacrifice part, because no matter what, you're gonna have to make sacrifices. And sometimes that's a conversation you have to have with your people in your household, your loved ones, your family. My wife Tristan and I were like, Trista was very like, you guys know Trish, like she openly admits she hates working out. Even to this day, she hates working out. So when I started my own health and weight loss journey, I had to have that conversation with her. Like, I know that you don't quite see it as the way I do, but I need this time. So I had to sacrifice an hour a day of our family time after work, back when I was doing massage therapy full time. And I had to let her know up front, like, hey, I really need support on this. So I just need like 45 to 60 minutes a day. And she allowed that to happen. So that was amazing. So that was a sacrifice I had to make. And then it went from there, and then just became an everyday normal part of my life. And she, now we're to a point, I started years ago. Now we're to a point where she knows it's not even an option. I have to have that morning workout. It's part of who I am. It's part of my routine. That's how I operate. You'd be probably the same way. If you miss your workout, it just domino affects your whole day.
Yeah, I was watching a video from this guy, and it kind of connected with me. He says if he misses his workout, because he's had the routine for like a couple of years now, he gets headaches. Like, wow. If I miss like my morning workout, or I miss my, like, because I have a routine in terms of, like, I usually do like a 2 hour, like, it's like a blast off, or like I have different names for it, but like I have a workout and then I do at least 2 hours of just full blown like grind.
Nice.
If I miss either one of those, like I start to feel off and like depressed.
Yeah.
Like, my head might hurt. Like, it's weird. But yeah, you know, build that routine, that habit. It's gonna suck at first. I'm not gonna lie. Like, because I hired a personal trainer about a year ago. I've lost over 30 pounds, like building muscle, doing really well. But the first like 6 months, I hated every single day of that. And you know, even after a year, you're still gonna have days where you feel like crap. There's no way around it.
Like this morning.
Yeah. Yeah.
The alarm went off and we're like, nope, don't want to do it.
Luckily, I'm not gonna joke. Like, I took out a lot of pre-workout and a fresh green juice. I had a green juice bar at my freaking hotel. Like, I thought I was in heaven, but you guys can do it. Anybody can do it, you know? You know, we got someone on your channel saying, I get sick every time I start working out.
Ouch.
So you might have to, maybe, some people don't like working out on an empty stomach.
Yeah, that's a factor too, is play around with different strategies, right? So if you look at tactics behind it, try working out on an empty stomach with something like branched chain amino acids, which is basically,
that's a good tip.
Yeah, like electrolytes, so it makes you feel good. So try empty stomach workouts, which I can't work out with food in my stomach. So I do fasting.
Yeah, I like the morning fast as well.
So we're both fans of that. But other people, they have to have some type of small meal so they have the energy.
Yeah.
So play around with both. And if you're brand new, you're gonna get lightheaded sometimes. You're gonna feel like crap. You may feel sick.
Yeah, that happened a lot.
Baby step it. Like, you don't have to jump in an hour a day. I tell people all the time, I would much rather you just stay consistent with a 15-minute walk every day than try to go hit the gym hard once a week. It's consistency over time.
Start slow as well. So many people, they're like, oh, I'm gonna start working out, and they jump into P90X.
Oh my gosh.
Like, I jumped into P90X the first time I worked out, like, I wouldn't be here making this video.
Yeah.
I'd probably be dead.
Yeah. Yeah, you'd be sore as crap, all that stuff.
Start slow. Start with a little bit of a walk, 5, 10, move it to 15 minutes. Then, you know, if you don't know what you're doing, hire a personal trainer. I can't say enough. Like, honestly, I never would have had my transformation. And you guys could check me out on Instagram, Rake and Profit, if you guys aren't.
Yeah.
I just put up a transformation pic, but that wasn't easy. Like, that took a lot of hard work and slow progression and just progression overload, which you mentioned, pushing yourself in the gym. But you guys can do it. I'm telling you right now, guys, if you get fit, if you get healthy, you're gonna be a better husband or a better wife. You're gonna be better in your business, more creative. Yeah. You're gonna enjoy life more, and you're gonna live longer, and you're gonna be able to give more. Because I feel like one of the biggest reasons why we're here on this earth is to make an impact, to make a difference. However it is, whether it's through your business or through your network or whatnot.
Yeah, 100%. It all ties back. The people on Sidehustle Pros hear me preach this too, and I'm sure they're getting tired of it. But one phrase I love and I preach over and over and over is, if you feel your best, you give your best. Just like you said, to everything. And I know people don't like, especially because we run reselling channels, right? You guys are here for like the business stuff, but we're here to break the mold and let you guys know, like, if you want a rockin' business, you've got to have this on point. The mentality, the physical health, like, you've got to have that on point. I'm telling you, it will blow everything up in your life more than you know.
We live in a world where it's not how hard you work. Working hard is important, but what's more important is making sure you're climbing up the right ladder. Mm-hmm. And to know what ladder to go up, you've got to be creative and you've got to be able to think. Your mind has to be sharp. Maybe some people out there can be sharp when they feel like crap. For me, if I feel like crap, I'm not sharp. I have so many amazing ideas come about as of late, the last couple months. My income's been going up like crazy, and I'm working less. I know it sounds crazy, but it's true. Yeah. Like, I feel better. Like, we live in a world now, especially with the internet, it's not like 1950s and 60s. The harder work, you make more money. Like, you can literally outthink yourself. You can think your way to the next tier.
Oh, totally. We're definitely in an age where you don't have to trade.
That's not BS.
Time.
Yeah.
For the money anymore.
So, I mean, I think we should leave it at that, man. I think we hit him with some really, really good points there. I'd be curious to know what you guys think in the comments, whether you're watching on the Side Hustle Pros. If you're on Rake and Profit, go check out Side Hustle Pros. I'll link that up probably down below.
And vice versa, because we got two recordings going on right now.
Right, right.
Check out Rake and Profit. We had this guy on our show not too long ago. No, we were on your show, weren't we?
Yeah, you were on my show. It gets confusing because it just felt like we were on our own show. Like, I felt like we were just having fun, you know?
Yeah, for sure. And that's what it's all about. That's why we do all this. It's all to have fun, make an impact, build a community, and just, man, rock it.
We got a plane going on. These planes have been coming in, man. Like, hardcore, man.
Yeah.
Vegas.
Apologize for the audio if it's cutting.
Yeah, yeah. But, yeah, thanks for having me on the channel, on the Side Hustle Pros, everyone on Rake and Profit. Appreciate you guys watching. Like,
thank
comment, subscribe. Check it out, and yeah, links down below.
Awesome, love it. Yeah, we'll link up all the channel information, Instagram. Check out this guy's Instagram, all the photos we got up today.
We had the perfect lighting in here.
Man.
We look so jacked, we're not even close to that.
We had the typical
that.
Bro lighting that was directly overhead.
They're gonna meet us in real life and be like, dude, you looked way more jacked at Planet Fitness.
I just need that light.
I sound so douchey right now. I apologize.
You know, we could PL something that has an overhead light that just follows
you. Oh man, that would be awesome. Hey, maybe at ASD they have it.
Hey, you never know. Let's go find some PL suppliers.
Cool. All right, guys.
Awesome. You guys have a great day. Peace out. Be blessed. We'll see you next time.
All right. See you guys.